Okay, so to begin with, we have that the incomplete table and pictogram show information about the number of burgers sold in a restaurant last week. We've got to use the information to complete the table and the pictogram. So let's complete the frequency table to begin with. We want to find the frequency of how many burgers were sold on Tuesday and Thursday. So we can do that because we can see for the days of Tuesday and Thursday, our pictogram is actually complete. We can see on Tuesday, we have 2.5 circles. And on Thursday, we have 4.5 circles. So now we use the key to find the frequency. So looking at the key, we can see that a full circle represents 2 burgers. So on Tuesday, we have 2 of these full circles, which represent 2 burgers. And then we have a semicircle. So if a full circle represents 2 burgers, then half a circle would represent 1 burger. So now all we need to do is add these numbers together. If we do 2 plus 2 plus 1, that's going to give us 5. So 5 burgers were sold on Tuesday. And we're going to do exactly the same thing for Thursday. All of these complete circles represent 2 burgers. And this semicircle will represent 1 burger. So now if we add all those numbers together, well, we've got 2 times 4, which is 8. Add on the 1. That'd give us 9. So 9 burgers would have been sold on Thursday. So we now have a complete frequency table. Let's now complete our pictogram. So for Monday, we know that 8 burgers were sold. So to now draw this, well, we know that a full circle represents 2 burgers. So we're going to need 4 full circles. So that'd be 2, 4, 6, and 8. Now for Wednesday, while looking at our frequency table, we can see that 4 burgers were sold on Wednesday. So again, a full circle would represent 2 burgers. So we're going to need 2 of these. So that would be 2 and 4. And then finally, on Friday, there were 11 burgers sold. So going through our pictogram again, a full circle represents 2 burgers. So we've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. We now need 1 more burger. So just like before, we're not going to draw a full circle this time. We're going to draw a semicircle, as the semicircle would represent 1 burger. So that would be it. We've completed our frequency table, and we've also completed our pictogram. So let's have a look at one more example. Okay, for this question, we have that the incomplete pictogram shows information about the number of chocolate bars sold in a shop last week. 24 chocolate bars were sold on Wednesday, 10 chocolate bars were sold on Thursday, and 30 chocolate bars were sold on Friday. We need to use the information given to complete the pictogram and find out how many chocolate bars were sold in total that week. So looking at our pictogram, if we take a look at our key, we can see we need to fill this in. We need to see how many chocolate bars that this big square represents. And to figure that out, we can use the information that we were given in the question. We were told on certain days how many chocolate bars were sold. So let's just write this to the left of the days. So we were told 24 chocolate bars were sold on the Wednesday. So let's write that here. 10 chocolate bars were sold on the Thursday. And 30 chocolate bars were sold on the Friday. So we have our pictures in our pictogram for Wednesday. And we also have the frequency, as we were told that 24 chocolate bars were sold on Wednesday. So we can now use that to find our key. Well, we can see on Wednesday, we have 3 of these big squares. And we know that the total frequency for Wednesday must be 24. So if we do 24 divided by 3, that'd give us 8. So that must mean that each of these big squares represents 8. So now going over to our key, we can fill this in. Our big square would represent 8 chocolate bars. And we can now use that to complete the pictogram. So for Thursday, 10 chocolate bars were sold. So looking back at our key, if this big square represents 8 chocolate bars, we're going to have one of these big squares. And then looking back at the key, we can see that our big square is made up of little squares. And there's four of these little squares in a big square. So if we do 8 divided by 4, that's going to give us 2. We can see that all these little squares must represent 2 chocolate bars. So we can use that to help us finish off our pictogram for Thursday, because we've done 1 big square, which is equal to 8, and now we only need 2 more. So going back to our key, we just need 2, so that would just be a quarter of the big square, or one of these little squares. So that would be our pictogram for Thursday. And then for Friday, we need 30, but we know these big squares represent 8 chocolate bars. So we'd have 8, 16, 24, and then we'd have 6 left. So we don't need a big square this time. We need 3 of the smaller squares. So we can draw it like this. And that would be our pictogram for Friday. So we've completed our pictogram, but we were also told to find out how many chocolate bars were sold in total that week. So we need to find the frequency for Monday and Tuesday. Well, we figured out our key, so we can go back and find the frequency. Well, if we do Tuesday first, we can see we've got 2 big squares. Well, we know a big square represents 8 chocolate bars, so 2 of them must represent 16. And then for Monday, we've got 2 big squares, which represent 8 chocolate bars each. And then we've got half a big square, or 2 little squares. Well, if it's half of a big square, that must represent 4. So if we do 8 plus 8 plus 4, that's going to give us 20. So now all we have to do to figure out how many total chocolate bars were sold is add up all the frequencies for each day. And if we do that, we should get 100. So there were 100 total bars sold that week. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. If you want to check out any other videos on statistics, then I'll leave a link for my statistics playlist down in the description below, and I'll also put a link for it in the top corner of this video. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.